You'll notice that there's no insert in your bulletin. There are only a few announcements. The first one is fairly obvious. Pastor Diane is on a well-deserved break, and she'll be back next week for the service. Today is our music minister's, also known as Al Sly. It's his last service before his official retirement. And we all give thanks. This is not an announcement. We all give thanks for his gifts and for his sharing them with us. This is to welcome you all, a prayer of welcome. Welcome all. Thank you for being here with us at the third annual Deacon's Service. We show God appreciation for his gift of music, and so abundant in this congregation. We bless Lee Collins, who will lead a hymn sing instead of a sermon. When the service is concluded, please join us for fellowship in the fellowship hall. And now, please say a prayer for the person sitting next to you, and in the silence that follows, prepare yourself for today's service. And now, if we can pray together, the call to worship, which you find in your bulletin. We come together today, called by your grace. God, we sing your praises with our voices, and thank you for sending your Son, who taught us to love one another as you have loved us. We gather now, readying ourselves to sing and pray together. And the prayer of invocation, calling God into our hearts and to be with us today. Holy, loving God, who loves each of us as you love your Son, we know you are with us. Your Holy Spirit is in the joyful music we play and sing for you today. You are here living with us in every act of generosity and word of kindness we show each other, your precious children. Amen.
Good morning. The prayer of confession to be read in unison. Almighty and merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare those who confess their faults. Restore thou those who are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O merciful Father, for his sake, that we may live a godly, righteous, and sober life. To the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Hear us now as we turn to you in silent confession, seeking your mercy, forgiveness, and grace. I pray that God will fill you with the knowledge of God's will through all the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please God in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened with all power according to God's glorious might, so that you may have great endurance and patience. Friends, hear now the good news. God has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of Christ Jesus, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. Let us sing praise to the Lord.
Psalm 148, page 716 in the Pew Bible. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights.
Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts.
Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars.
Praise him,
let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created.
He established them forever and ever. He fixed their bounds, which shall not be passed.
Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all deeps, fire and hail,
snow
and frost, stormy wind fulfilling his command. Mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars.
Wild animals and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds.
Kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the earth.
Young men and women alike, old and young together.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His glory is above earth and heaven.
He has raised up a horn for his people, praise for all his faithful.
Praise the Lord. And the Old Testament reading is found in Isaiah chapter 61 verses 10 and 11 and chapter 62 verses 1 to 3, page 846 and 847 in the Pew Bible. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I will not rest until her vindication shines out like the dawn and her salvation like a burning torch. The nations shall see your vindication and all the kings your glory, and you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. Let's join together in hymn number 488. Go tell it to the mountain.
God is all about abundance, love that never wavers, mercy that never fails. As we reach the end of 2014 and look forward to the challenges and the potential of the coming year, let us offer our gifts generously and in abundant love as a thanksgiving to God. The morning offering will now be received. Gifts, dear God, accept the praise and thanksgiving of our hearts, which rejoice in your goodness and your love. Let our gifts point to your presence in the world and do your transforming work among all who are vulnerable and in need.
Good morning. Music is an inherent part of every society. The unearthly sounds of throat singing in Mongolia and Siberia are as important to their cultures as Bach is to European cultures, or drum-driven song and dance are to Native American cultures. Since music is such an important part of life, it should not be surprising that the Bible says much about it. In fact, the longest book in the Bible is the songbook, Psalms. In addition to Psalms, there are other song and poetry-focused books, such as Song of Solomon, Ecclesiastes, and others. In the New Testament, we have song lyrics recorded in Revelations, the mention of Jesus and the disciples singing in Matthew, and the example of the apostles singing in Acts. Many people also consider Mary's Magnificat in Luke chapter 1 and the angel's announcement in Luke chapter 2 to be songs. Music is infused throughout the Bible as it is in this church through the talents, dedication, and direction of our beloved Al Sly. I have chosen three readings from the New Testament. The first one binds music with love, something that Al has always done. The second reading asks us to sing and make melody to God with all our hearts, which again is something that Al has always asked his choir to do and which we have always done gladly for him. The third reading speaks for itself. We praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, but today we also praise dear Al Sly. Hear now from these verses in the New Testament. From Corinthians chapter 13. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver up my body to be burned, but have nothing, but have not love, I gain nothing. And from Ephesians, therefore do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. And do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with your heart, giving thanks always for everything to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And finally, from Colossians, let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness in your hearts to God. And whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Here ends the reading.
Hymn sing time. And with nothing scheduled, we're going to sing what you'd like to sing. Let's observe two things. First of all, maybe three things. First of all, just kindly raise your hand, and I'll pick on you because we've got plenty of time. You get to choose the hymn, and it can be Easter, it can be anything you want, any season you want. Why should we leave all the good stuff to a particular holiday? And we'll sing the first verse, and you get to pick what second verse, because every hymn will sing two verses, the first verse and the second verse of your choice. And the third thing is that I get to pick the first one. So we're going to start with number 429. I love this. In the Navy hymn, Eternal Father, Strong to Save. And by the way, when you're leafing through things, don't forget the supplement. We've got some good stuff in here that we don't sing perhaps often enough. So don't forget the supplement. Eternal Father, Strong to Save. And we're going to do the first verse and the fourth, verses 1 and 4. 429. Here he goes. Verses 1 and
4.
1 and 4 of 433.
Father, Father, Son,
balcony. You don't have to stand up the whole time. Everybody else is... Okay, well, go to it.
Oh,
if you like this, you might, you'd love coming to the church in the Wildwood in the summertime. It's a little church way out in the woods up in Colebrook that is run by a private group of people that formed a foundation after the Baptist church back in 1950 said we were going to have to abandon this church because there's just not enough people coming to it. So 60 years later, the church is still thriving as a summertime church. Diane preaches there once a summer, and each Sunday there's a different preacher, preaches gratis, nobody's paid. Barb plays the piano, I lead the hymn sing because it's called a Vesper service, and we sing 20 minutes out of an old Baptist hymnal that you would love. It is really, I mean, hymnals are such a resource. Such beauty, such poetry, and such meaning, and each one is different. In that is the Battle Hymn of the Republic. Okay, 1 and 4, up number 443. Summertime services are held between July and Labor Day, and they're 7 o'clock every Sunday night, rain or whatever. We're always there, and it's a beautiful little service. Sing Choirs of Angels. All right.
Oh, Lord, as Carol mentioned, today we once again sang our desire to praise God from whom all blessings flow. Now, we wish to acknowledge one very special blessing that you have bestowed upon us for nearly five decades so far. Mr. Al Sly, God, you have through all those years gifted so many assembled here in your name, as well as the greater community in which we live, with a man who in your service has faithfully composed, performed, and guided so much wonderful music for so long and so beautifully and with so much inspiration to us all. Let us demonstrate our gratitude to Al and to you, Lord, by trying each in our own way to be inspired to emulate Al's example of unfaltering dedication and service to this congregation and to the world beyond. And we ask you, please, to continue to protect and watch over Al, for we love him dearly. And now, Lord, we ask you to provide your solace and your protection for the people of Sierra Leone and Ebola who are suffering from Ebola and their caretakers, and for Mark Lundin and family, and for all those on our prayer list. And now let us join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
like to conclude this morning's service with a piece written by Reverend Quinn Caldwell. He's the author of Still Speaking Devotionals that you can get delivered to from the UCC site on a daily basis. And this was one that I saw about a week ago, and it was so appropriate for Al that I'd like to read it to you. Reverend Caldwell says, "I remember my mother teaching me to sing Silent Night. I remember my sister teaching me, O Come All Ye Faithful. I remember how much my grandmother loved The Little Drummer Boy, and so I love it too. As soon as Mary gets together with her relative Elizabeth, she starts to sing a Christmas song. We don't know where she learned it, or who taught it to her, or if Elizabeth knew it too, or if they had ever sung it together before. But I bet neither of them ever forgot that moment. Who taught you the songs of the season? At whose knee or on whose breast did you first breathe them in? Whose face appears before you whenever you hear them? Today, sing a carol or two for all the Elizabeths out there, the family members, whether by blood or otherwise, with whom you've given voice to the faith of this season. Sing for Jesus, of course, but sing for what we learned in him, the nurture of a fathering God, the strength of a mothering God, the delight of a wacky aunt or a zany uncle God, the love of an adopting God. If you're lucky enough to be able to do it, go find the person that taught you a song or call him and ask him to sing with you. If you can't reach him anymore, sing with her anyway and praise God's name. God, thank you for the family that taught my soul to magnify you. Hear me as I sing your praises with them today. Amen."